JR and Blake from Pig Destroyer. We're here at Generation Records. We're about to go shopping. They want you to
fade into the background. I have a pretty big record collection. I'm a record nerd, but with my vinyl, I like the idea of playing them. They're not all pristine. They're not all in sleeves. I've got a lot of 80s pop, a lot of 80s pop, a lot of 80s new wave, 70s rock, a lot of old punk, a lot of old hardcore, and obviously metal. Probably my most treasured is, I got two. One is Samhain, Unholy Passion, signed by Glenn Danzig. And there's 500 copies forever printed. So I have that, and then I have a Police single, the Can't Stand Losing You single, that the cover was banned because it's a guy hanging himself with a block of ice method, and the label was like, no, you can't do that. So I've got, those are my two big ones. You know, it's mostly for me, it's the format, like, you know, the size is like, that's how you're supposed to see the artwork. You pull it out of the record. It is kind of a pain in the ass to put away and, you know, file, and like, if it gets too humid in your basement or whatever, you're like, oh, my records. But like, you know, just the whole aspect of pulling the record out, the act of it.
Yeah, I'm a CD guy, but we're kind of a dying breed these days. I order a lot of CDs from Japan and like on Discogs and stuff because they still print CDs of new things, you know. I also like slam metal a lot, and they still like to do a lot of CDs, so that's pretty cool. I actually prefer the sound of vinyl, but it's just always, for me, I'm a person who I don't sit still a lot, and you know, so I listen to a lot of music in the car and things like that. The most important CD to me is my Dead Boy and the Elephant Man demo that I ordered from them when they first came out. Like, it's a super rare demo. I've never met anybody else who has it, and I don't think I've ever seen it online. So I kind of almost protect it like I protect my wedding ring. Like, sometimes I stop and I have to think, like, where's my Dead Boy CD, and then I have to go make sure it's okay.
Okay, so this is Verbal Assault, The Trial, and this is their second full length. This is a life-changing record to me. I saw them at the Fireside Bowl in Chicago on this tour, and had not heard this record, and it was just very aggressive hardcore that was way different for the time. And actually, I'd say that, I don't know if it's a direct influence, but Integrity kind of took a page out of their book. I hear a lot of Verbal Assault and Integrity. Just a killer fucking record. I mean, this is flawless.
Okay, so the first piece that I pulled out was Megadeth, So Far, So Good, So What. This is their third album and my personal favorite one. It has probably their least good drummer. He's still really good, but I mean, Gar Samuelson and Nick Menza are pretty sick, you know. I just love the darkness of this record. I think it's their darkest, most kind of evil record, and it's just got a great atmosphere. And Dave Mustaine, it sounds like he wants to kill everybody on it. And I mean, that's what you want out of a metal record, right?
All right, so this is Misfits' Walk Among Us. So basically, like everyone my age, I got into metal because of Metallica. At the time, Metallica had a lot of Pusshead artwork and pumped the shit out of Danzig and the Misfits. So, you know, I figured if it's good enough for And Justice for All era Metallica, it's good enough for me. So I think I went to Laurel Mall in Laurel, Maryland, and they had the Walk Among Us tape on the Ruby Records imprint, and I bought it, and this was the first one I bought. This is my first exposure to the Misfits. I used to have a Misfits tattoo that was probably one of the shittiest tattoos you've ever seen, ever in the history of tattoos. So this is Walk Among Us. There's not a bad song on this record. Every single thing about this record is great.
The second piece here is, again, a recent re-release, and I think this may have been remixed as well. A lot of people didn't like the original production on this album, but the material is amazing, and I think it sounds great. Sick guitar leads and Dwid doing his apocalyptic Integrity craziness.
So being like a hardcore kid and a punk kid and a metal kid in the, you know, late 80s, early 90s, this huge Black Flag fan. Well, there's only so much Black Flag material until you find out about Blast, which is basically Black Flag Jr. In fact, I think there's some interview I read with Henry Rollins where he said, Flag played with this band tonight, and they totally ripped Black Flag off. That band was called Blast. That made me instantly want to go out and get this record, which I did. So this is a fucking awesome record if you're into Black Flag. This is a Black Flag tribute band, basically. A little different, but still Flag. Very, like, aggressive hardcore punk.
And then the third piece here is my favorite Dead Kennedys album, Frank and Christ. This is like not just unique in their discography, but I think in rock music in general, I've never heard another record that's like this. And Jello is at the height of his character playing powers, and he's pretending to be rednecks, and then all kinds of weird things are happening on this record. And the last song on side B, Stars and Stripes of Corruption, is probably the best political lyric I think I've ever read.
Thanks for checking out our picks. You can pick up Head Cage.
Get it here at Generation Records.
We're at Generation Records. Make sure you smash that like button on Metal Injection.
Head
like
Cage.
85 times.